Hello friends, welcome to lecture number 4 of unit number 5, Web Security. Myself Nikhil Jaiswal, lecturer in Computer Engineering, Sri KG Polytechnic, Bharuch. Let's have a quick recap of our previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we have discussed the web security consideration. So many of the organization use the website for their product information and various other information. And they also use the website for the various operations like online selling of the product. And many of the organization will have the web server, and web server will also have some confidential information about the organization. So web security, we need to consider the web security as a serious note, because website also include the major confidential informations. After that, we have seen the web security threats. So there are several web security threats based on the some parameters. So we have seen the web security threats for the integrity, then confidentiality, then availability, and then authentication also. So we have already discussed the web security threats. And after that, we have seen the web traffic security approaches. So these are the approaches that can be used to secure the web traffic. So we have, in the previous lecture, we have discussed the major three approaches that can be used to deal with the web traffic security. First is IPsec, that can be work on the network layer. And after that, we have seen the SSL, that is secure socket layer, that is the security approach for the transport layer. And after that, we have seen the third approach, that is application specific web security approaches like Kerberos and another application related security approaches. Now in today's lecture, we will discuss the major topic, that is secure socket layer and transport layer security. So we will discuss the secure socket layer in detail, and we will also discuss the transport layer security. And after that, we will discuss the secure electronic transaction. So basically, secure electronic transaction is will deal with the online payment from the credit cards. So let's start with the first topic, that is secure socket layer. So SSL is designed to provide the security and compression service to data generated from the application layer. So basically, secure socket layer will provide the security to your data which is going to transfer from the internet. So internet is the unsecure network. So to provide the security on the internet, we use the secure socket layer. So basically, secure socket layer will provide the compression service also, and it will provide the security service also for the data that has been generated by the application layer. So whenever the application layer generate any data, for that data, security will be provided by the secure socket layer. So typically, SSL can receive data from any application layer protocol, but usually the protocol is HTTP. So we are right now discussing the web traffic security. So SSL can receive data from any application layer protocol, but SSL was basically designed for the security for the HTTP. So whenever HTTP generate any data, that means if any client access the website, then that client server communication will be go through the HTTP service, and HTTP service will generate the data at the application level, and that data will be non-secure, and the security will be provided by the SSL. So the data received from the application is compressed and signed and encrypted by the secure socket layer. The data is then passed to the reliable transport layer protocol such as TCP. So the SSL will work above the TCP. Clear? So Netscape developed the SSL in 1994, and version 2 and 3 were released in 1995. SSL provides several services on data received from the application layer. So these are the services that has been provided by the SSL. The first service provided by the secure socket layer is the fragmentation. So fragmentation means dividing the data. So SSL will divide the data into block of 24 bytes or less. After that, it will also perform the compression. So each fragment of the data is compressed using one of the lossless compression. So lossless compression means after compressing the data will not be lost. And the method for the compression will be negotiated between the client and server. So client and server mutually decide which compression technique will be used. So first of all, when the application layer data sends some data to the below layer, the SSL will divide that data into 24 bytes and it will compress the data. After that, it will provide the message integrity. That means unauthorized modification will not be done if we use the SSL. So for the integrity of the data, SSL uses a keyed hash function to create a MAC. MAC means message authentication code. So it will use the hash function to provide the message integrity. So hash function we have already seen in the previous units. Then it will also provide the confidentiality. So to provide the confidentiality, the original data and the MAC are encrypted using the symmetric key cryptography. So SSL will use the symmetric key cryptography to provide the confidentiality. And lastly, it will provide the framing also. A header is added to encrypted payload. The payload is then passed through the reliable transport layer protocol. So all the information related to encryption will be stored into that framing. So basically SSL will provide these five functionality. First is fragmentation, second is compression, third is message integrity, fourth is confidentiality, and fifth is framing. Now HTTP protocol will not provide the integrity and the confidentiality. So to provide the integrity and confidentiality to the HTTP, we will use the secure socket layer. After providing all these mechanism, after implementing all this mechanism, the packet will be passed to the transport layer protocol. So SSL is designed to make the use of TCP to provide a reliable end-to-end secure service. So TCP provide the reliable end-to-end service, and the SSL will used above the TCP to provide the secure service. So SSL is not a single protocol, but rather two layers of protocol. So basically SSL is not a single protocol. We have two layers of protocol in the SSL. So the first layer is called as a SSL record protocol, and the second layer will combine these three protocols. So basically in the SSL there are four protocols. First is SSL record protocol, second is SSL handshake protocol, third is SSL change cipher specification protocol, and fourth is SSL alert protocol. So SSL is not a single protocol, it is the combination of four various protocol, and it has a two layers. In the first layer, we will have only one protocol, that is called as the SSS record protocol. And in the second layer, we will have the three other protocols. The SSL record protocol provide the basic security services to various higher level protocols. So the main working of the SSL record protocol is to provide the security for the particular data. So in the particular, the HTTP, which provide the transfer service for the web client server interaction, can operate on top of SSL. So HTTP will work on the top of the SSL. HTTP will not provide the security. So the basic work of the HTTP is to provide the client server interaction for the web traffic, and the security for that HTTP will be provided by the SSL. So three higher level protocol are defined as part of SSL: the handshake protocol, the change cipher specification protocol, and the alert protocol. So these SSL specific protocols are used in the management of SSL exchange. So these three protocols will be used for the management of SSL, and actual security for the data will be provided by the SSL record protocol. Two important SSL concepts are SSL session and SSL connection, which are defined in the specification as follow. So there are two main topics in SSL, concepts in SSL. First is connection and second is session. Now we will discuss what is connection. So a connection is a transport that provides a suitable type of service. So basically connection will transport the data from one to another end. In the OSI layering model definition, so a connection is a transport that provides a suitable type of service. So for SSL, such connection are peer-to-peer relationship, that is end-to-end relationship between the two end machines. So every connection is associated with one session. Now what is session is? A session is an SSL session is an association between client and a server. Sessions are created by a handshake protocol. Sessions define a set of cryptographic security parameters which can be shared among the multiple connections. That means before establishing any before sending any data to or before transmitting any data between two machines or the client and server, session will be created. Now session will be created by the handshake protocol, and in that session the cryptographic security parameters will be shared. That means in the SSL we are using the symmetric key algorithm. That means for the encryption and for the decryption the key will be same. So the key shared will be done by the sessions. Now we will discuss the four protocols. Now first is SSL record protocol. So the SSL record protocol provide the two services for the SSL connection. First is confidentiality. So handshake protocol defines a shared secret key that is used for the conventional encryption of SSL payload. Clear? So before establishing the connection, that will be the shared key will be secret key will be shared by the two users, because in the SSL we are using the symmetric key algorithm. So for the encryption and the decryption, the key will be the same, and that key distribution will be done by the handshake protocol. So the SSL record protocol will provide two major services. The first is confidentiality. That means only authorized user will able to access the information or packets. So the handshake protocol defines a shared secret key that is used for the conventional encryption for SSL payload. And second services that has been provided by the SSL record protocol is message integrity. So the handshake protocol also defines a shared secret key that is used to form a message authentication code. It is also called as a MAC, or we can call it as a hash value. SSL record protocol operations. So these are the operations that will be performed by the SSL record protocol. So first there will be application data. What the SSL will do, it will fragment the data. That means it will divide the data into smaller parts. Now it will compress the data. It will calculate the hash value, or we can also call it as a MAC value. That MAC value will be appended. Now whole this data will be encrypted, and we will append the SSL record header in front of data. So this is the basic operation in the SSL record protocol. It will take the data from the application. It will fragment the data. That means it will divide the data. It will take the first part of data. It will compress that data, and it will calculate the MAC. And the MAC will be added here. MAC will be also called as a message authentication code, or you can simply take it as a hash value. It will calculate the hash value for this portion, and the hash value will be appended here. Now whole this data will be encrypted by the symmetric key algorithm, and the header will be appended here. Now next is the change cipher specification protocol. So change cipher spec protocol is one of the three SSL specific protocol that use the SSL record protocol in its simplest. This protocol contain of a single message which consists of a single byte with value 1. The purpose of this message is to cause the pending state to be copied into a current state, which update the cipher so to be used on this connection. The change cipher specification protocol will use to change the state of the SSL. So there will be a pending state for the encryption, and the current state it will change the pending state into the current state when the update of the cipher set to be used for the next connection. Next is the alert protocol. So alert protocol is used to convey the SSL related alerts to the peer entity. That means it will generate the alerts for the particular scenarios. As with other application that use SSL, alert message are compressed and encrypted as specified by the current state. Next is handshake protocol. So this will basically used to establish the session. So the most complex part of the SSL is the handshake protocol. This protocol allows the server and client to authenticate each other, and to negotiate an encryption and MAC algorithm and cryptographic key to be used to protect the data sent in SSL record. So basically in the handshake protocol, both the client and server will authenticate with each other, and they will decide which encryption and decryption algorithm will be used and which MAC algorithm will be used. After deciding the encryption and decryption algorithm, they will share the secret key for the encryption and decryption purposes. So this will done in the handshake protocol. The handshake protocol is used before any application data is transmitted. And the handshake protocol consists of a series of messages exchanged by the client and server. Now, next topic is the transport layer security. Now, we have gone through the secure socket layer. Now, secure socket layer is the topic, and the implementation of the secure socket layer is called as a transport layer security. So, TLS is the IETF standardization initiative whose goal is to produce an internet standard version of SSL. So, TLS will be called as an internet standard version of SSL. That means this TLS will be used as a SSL in internet. So TLS is defined as a proposed internet standard which is very similar to SSL version 3. The TLS record format is the same as that of the SSL record format, and the field in the header have the same meaning. The one difference in the version value. For the current version of TLS, the major version is 3 and the minor version is 3. So the actual implementation of the SSL secure socket layer is called as a transport layer security. So this was all about the secure socket layer and transport layer security. Now we will discuss the next more important topic, that is secure electronic transactions. So it is also called as a SET. And SET is an open source encryption and security specification which is designed for protecting the credit card transaction on the internet. So whenever we purchase anything from the internet, then we will do the online payment, and that data will be goes through the internet. So to secure that data, the mechanism will be used, and that mechanism will be called as a secure electronic transaction. So remember that a secure electronic transaction is not a payment system. It is a set of security protocols and format that ensure that using online payment, transaction on the internet is secure. So SET is not a payment system, but it will provide the security for the online payment. So secure electronic transaction is also called as a SET. SET provides a secure environment for all the parties that are involved in the e-commerce transaction. It also ensures the confidentiality, and it provides the authentication through the digital certificate. So SET is not some system that enables the payment, but it is the security protocol applied on those payments. It uses different encryption and hashing technique to secure the payments over internet done through credit cards. So whenever you do any payment through the credit card, then SET protocol will be used for the security of that payment. Now, SET protocol was supported in development by major organizations like Visa, MasterCard, Microsoft, which provide its secure transaction technology, and Netscape, which provide the technology of secure socket layer. General scenario of the electronic transaction. So there will be a customer, there will be a merchant, and there will be a payment gateway. Now customer will have its own financial institute, and merchant will have its own financial institute. Now these four parameters, these four parties will be included in the secure payment, and payment gateway will help to transfer the money from the customer financial institute to the merchant financial institute, and all the whole transaction will be done by the customer, and security will be provided to this transaction will be provided by the secure electronic transaction. So requirement in SET is it has to provide mutual authentication. That means customer authentication by confirming if the customer is instead intended user or not the merchant authentication. It has to keep the payment information and order information confidential. It has to be resistive against message modification. That means no changes should be allowed. Then SET also need to provide interoperability and make user based security mechanism. That means interoperability means all the merchant financial institutes should provide the flexibility to operate. Then participants in SET. So in general scenario of online transaction, SET includes similar participants. Card holder will be the participant of the SET, that is customer, then issuer, customer financial institute, then merchant, then acquirer, that is also called as a merchant financial, and certificate authority. So authority which follows certain standard and issue certificate to all other participants. SET functionalities. So it will provide the authentication, and merchant authentication will be provided by the SET to prevent the theft SET allows customer to check previous relationship between the merchant and financial institute. Second is customer or cardholder authentication. SET check if the use of credit card is done by the authorized user or not. Then provide message confidentiality. It will also provide the confidentiality to the message. Confidentiality refers to preventing unintended people from reading the message being transferred. Then it will also provide the message integrity. SET doesn't allow message modification with the help of signature. So this was all about the secure socket layer, transport layer security and secure electronic transaction SET. I hope you did understand all the topics that has been discussed in this video lecture. Thank you so much.